what's going on, everybody? I just wanted to do an update of all sorts, actually. I had so much going on and I haven't got a chance to sit down and just catch up. So I guess the first thing would be that I ran that half marathon, and it was awesome. It was on the 29th of last month, and I was really happy with how quickly I finished. You know, I'm sure the elite runners would laugh at my time, but I finished in an hour and 50 minutes, which for me, I was really happy with. It was an hour and 52 minutes, actually, I think. So it was a really good time. It was incredible, really. It was just an amazing feeling. It's the first time I've ever done anything of that distance. Even during my training, I only trained up to 12. Actually, I think only up to 11 miles, and then the race was 13.1. So it was really great, extremely invigorating, and it was just a blast. These were the shirts that the charity that I was running for we printed up for the runners. It's big shoes for little souls, and I was number 645. And it's all the people that supported the charity, which is really cool. It was just it was a great time. And I'd love to do it again. I don't know if I will. My knees really aren't built for running. I feel like I have the stamina, but my knees are just, I just have some brutal pain in my knees. So I might try one of those foam rollers to help, you know, loosen up the muscles in my IT band. Hopefully it'd be awesome if I could continue running, because I'd love to do another one. I'd actually really love to do a marathon, but that might just be something I'll dream about. What else? My chest has been healing up well. I'm hoping it's just swelling in the right pec. It's gone down way further than it was initially. I had so much swelling post-surgery, lots of swelling. It was bigger than it was before I went into the operating room. So it was a little concerning. But I'll show you my scars. So, it's awesome. He did a really great job of leaving my my tattoo intact. Let me just tilt this down a little more and zoom in. So, I don't know if you can even see it, but here, this is one incision, and this is another. So, tiny bit of the ink is missing on both sides, but nothing that can't be touched up. So, so eventually, you know, down the line, maybe in a couple of years or so, I'll touch it up. But in general, like, you can't tell that anything was changed. So, I feel comfortable with, you know, leaving it until it's fully healed, and, you know, if I do a little touch-up ink down the line, that's fine. But so just to letting it heal, the little bit of swelling that's still there, hopefully it'll continue to go down, and I'll just keep feeling more and more comfortable with it. And the last main thing that I want to update about is the Philadelphia Trans Health Conference that I attended with a few friends this past weekend, which was really, really cool. Took place in Philadelphia in Pennsylvania, and it was pretty cool. We drove down, actually, crazy story. There were five of us that went. We all carpooled to make it more economical. And we drove through a tornado that ripped through Springfield, Mass, which was really kind of scary, actually. We were in the car and it was raining really, really hard, and it started to hail, and people were just stopping in the middle of the highway, just stopping in their lanes. And then, like, hundreds of people were pulling off into this rest area, and it finally let up. It was crazy. There was lightning just, like, striking down, like, one after the other, all over the place. I'd never seen so much lightning, and it was just pouring. So the weather got a little bit better, people got back on the road, and then there was, like, a huge traffic jam. And about a half mile up the road, there were hundreds of trees snapped off at the middle, just snapped off, broken off, ripped out by the roots. There were highway signs down in the middle of the road, and it was a car tipped over in the middle of the two highways going in each direction. So it's kind of crazy because there's really never any tornadoes in Massachusetts. We just don't get weather like that. So it was crazy and a little scary. But yeah, so the conference was awesome. We drove down Wednesday evening. The conference was Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Was really great. I can show you the little programming booklet from it. It was really neat. If you didn't get to go this year and you're, you know, somewhat in the area, or even if you're not, you know, start planning for next year. There were so many people from all over the world there. You know, not just on you know, the eastern side of the nation. So there were tons of people. It was awesome, and the programming's great. They I feel like they really cover so much. There was tons of programming for people of color, Latinos, sex workers, partners, teens and children, like genderqueers, really just totally ran the gauntlet of all the different things that they covered at the conference. So if you went, I hope you had a great time. If you didn't, think about going next year. It was my first time going. It was a little overwhelming for me. I actually don't like big groups. It's too overstimulating for me, with so many people. Just kind of sensitive to the energy in my environment, and I tend to get overwhelmed in large groups. So that being said, I'm not quite sure why I volunteered to speak on a panel, but I did. And it was the panel was called What Happens If I Stop Taking Tea. And I thought it went okay. There were a good amount of people that showed up. Let's see if I can find it on this brochure. Yeah, here it is.
What happens if I stop taking testosterone?
So I actually received an email. And there's someone looking for people to speak on the panel, and I said yes, and so it was okay. There were a good amount of people. I'd say over 70 people in the workshop. I was really nervous. My left hand turned purple, actually. So it's really weird because it's totally different from going from talking to people through YouTube. Like, I'm the only one in the room right now, aside from my pets. I've done trainings and workshops before in high schools and for teachers and nurses and stuff. So it's not like it was the first time I'd done any public speaking, but I was really nervous. My left hand turned purple. The first like digits were going numb when I was in the panel because I was so nervous. But I think that it was helpful for a lot of people, at least I hope it was. It seemed like there were a lot of people that were either interested in what would happen if they stopped taking testosterone or had personally done it themselves. So it was really awesome to go into the panel and be like, yeah, we have a little bit of information. You know, the three people, the three trans men on this panel have stopped taking tea at some point, or, you know, or still off tea. But that really, as a community, you know, like, asking questions from the people in the audience and the audience asking the people on the panel questions, like, we really can all learn so much information from each other. So that was great. I was happy to participate in that and meet a bunch of people that I had spoken with online. It was awesome to meet people in person, and you guys were just really sweet. Anybody that came up to me and just, you know, shared some really, really heart felt words with me, it was awesome. So thank you, I really appreciate that. And yeah, I think that's it. The only last thing I wanted to cover was that there was this terrific guy at the conference doing body work for people. He was with Breema, Breema. I think his name might be John. It's on one of these papers. But if you had any body work done by this gentleman, I assume he identifies as male, but he was really a very sweet, kind, gentle compassionate person, and I just wanted to give him a little shout out because he's awesome. And he practices, it looks like it says Thursday night, 7 to 9 p.m., June 9th, 16th, and 23rd at Chestnut Hill, 100 East Mermaid Lane, if you're in Philadelphia. So, you know, definitely check that out. I'll leave his contact information attached to this video. He was doing body work on people from like 7 in the morning until 6 at night without any breaks. And I just thought he was a really incredible, amazing person. So if you're interested in Breema Bodywork, definitely check out the link that I attached to the video. I think that's it. Yeah, I had a great time at the conference, and seriously, people are just salt of the earth. So it was just incredible to be in a place where there's so many different people with a similar experience in life, you know, and that we can all be there to network and share our experiences and learn from one another. So I had a great time, and I hope to go again next year. Okay, take care, everybody. Bye.
Mother, there's too many of you crying. Brother, there's far too many of you dying. You know we've got to find a way to bring some love. Don't need to escalate. You see, war is not the answer, for only love can conquer hate. You know we've got to find a way to bring some love in here today. Picket lines and picket signs. Punish me, sister, with brutality, sister. Talk to me.